In this example, we're completing the square for both x and y. So first thing that we need to do is we have here's our x portion and here's our y portion. We're going to set the coefficients for x squared and y squared to 1. So out of the first portion there, we're going to factor out a negative 3. That will give me x squared. And negative 24 divided by negative 3 is going to be a positive 8x. And then I have what I'm going to add in there to complete my square. And again, I have to remember that whatever number I put in here at the end is going to be multiplied by a negative 3. And then on my y squared portion, I have to set it to a coefficient of 1. So I'm going to factor out a 4 out of it. So I'll factor out a 4. That will give me y squared. And negative 32 divided by 4 is negative 8y. And then I'll go ahead and add what I'm going to add in there. Again, whatever I add in here to complete this square, I'm going to multiply it by 4. And that's what gets added on both sides. So let's complete the square for the first one. I'm going to take that middle number, that 8. I'm going to divide it by, what am I dividing it by? 4. I need to divide it by 2. Then that will give me 4. I square that number, so I'm going to add 16 to both sides. Now, I have to take that 16 and multiply it by a negative 3. So negative 3 times 16 is a negative 48. So in essence, I've multiplied right here, I've added in a negative 48. So I have to add in the negative 48 to the other side. So for my y here, I'm going to go ahead and this will be a negative 8 divided by 2. That gives me negative 4. I square it. And that will give me a 16 that I add in there as well. Except on this side, now I'm going to be multiplying that 16 times 4. So in effect, I've actually added in a 64. So now I can go through and I can rewrite my equation to be negative 3x squared plus 8x plus 16 plus 4 times y squared minus 8y plus 16 is equal to, I have 8 minus 48 plus 64, and I add all those together and I get 24. Now for completing my square, I could have done this in the last step and that would have been fine, but this is going to be x plus 4 squared, and then I will have 4 is equal to y minus 4 squared is equal to 24. So now I have completed the square for both the x and y in the equation.